Moving an ant colony can be quite challenging. If there's one mistake plenty of new ant keepers, including myself, make, is moving your ants too soon into a nest that is too big for them. That is why in this video, I'm going to show you some examples of ant colonies inside nests and explain when to move your ants and to what size nest you should move them to. But first, the nest type. If your test tube colony is ready to move out, you have to decide which nest you use. Right now, there are a few nesting types like whitetongue, wood, 3D printed, acrylic, cork, plaster and natural. On the Aesthetic Ant store, you will mainly see 3D printed ant nests, but that will change in the future since having a different hydration option to choose from will be nice from time to time. You might think, is there a perfect nest that fits every species? The answer is of course no. The best thing you can do is ask fellow ant keepers what nest they use and take their advice. About the nests, I can make a whole other video, but right now we will focus on moving the ants. Let me know in the comments if you want to see that video. Alright, now the question is, when should I move my ants out of the test tube into a nest? Sadly, this is not a yes or no question, and everywhere you ask, people will say different things. So, here's my advice coming from an ant keeper and a shop owner. Keep your ants in a test tube for as long as possible. What exactly do I mean with this? The test tube is by far the best nest ever created for ants. If you want to make sure your ants do well, you keep them in a test tube. For a Camponotus species, this usually means plus minus 25 workers. For a larger species, this can be 100 to 200 ants. This of course depends on the size of the species, so the amount of workers I'm talking about is a rough guideline. You should also move your colony when it becomes impossible to feed them inside a test tube. You can, however, connect the test tube to an outworld to feed your colony. From a shop owner's perspective, I have seen customer colonies thrive most when moved in with greater numbers. If you can't wait to move them, move the ants when the second generation of workers hatches. Then your colony will be big enough to care for themselves, usually that is. AntsCheck provided me with some great information, and this picture that further explains when to move your ants. He said a good guideline is that the ants should cover at least half of the nest with workers. If it's less, you move them in too soon. Let's look at some examples so you can get a greater understanding when to move your ants. In this picture here, you can see a massive barbarous colony inside an aesthetic ant's small nest. As you can see, this colony has 20 to 30 workers. You can also see they have a lot more room inside the nest. So, did the person move the ants in at the right time? I would say yes. The reason being that Massobarbus needs seeds, and those seeds are hard for them to store inside a test tube. If this was not a harvester species, the nest would be too big, of course. Next up, we have this beautiful Camponotus colony inside a vertical ant nest. Don't worry, we will not only cover static ants nests in this video. As you can see, this is quite a good fit. The nest is decently occupied and there's some room for the ants to grow. You want all chambers somewhat occupied, so the ants don't start to fill the nest with trash. This trash pile can cause mold and will not only look bad, but can in some cases be bad for your colony as well. After all these examples, I will show you a couple more pictures. Do you recognize them? Yeah, they are all my colonies. Ants I moved into the nest way too fast. See, even I make these mistakes because moving ants into a nest that is perfectly sized for them takes practice and experience. Right now, I think I'm pretty decent at it. By keeping the ants in the test tube until I can't anymore, I managed to raise quite some colonies. And with that being said, we are at the end of this video. I hope you learned something. If you do, please leave a like and consider subscribing as it would help me a lot. Before this video ends, I'm going to play a bunch of pictures and will tell you if the nest is too big or a good size. Pause the video to see any nest in particular. Thank you so much for watching this video. Let's go!